Alright, so I'm gonna try to be election reprieve and not discuss it, because I know it's all in everybody's mind. Can we secede from the nation? Can we drop politics of USA and become our own? Or all of that, you know, because we had a big win here in the democratic direction, but then yet we lost the state to the Republicans in the Senate, so it didn't help, you know, our one little county vote time, as big and great and wonderful, it did not, it didn't clinch the state, you know. That we have the Cruz guy and he took over. They were naughty, because this, on the very morning of the vote day, they went out and they put these signs on all the corners. They're Republicans. They put signs out on the corner that said, taxes reduced when you vote the Republican way, you know. So they were pretty wretched politics they go at. They put that on every, like, major intersection, I noticed. So pretty ugly of them. And then they had women out there in red jackets. I mean, just standing there holding their signs, you know. I mean, just pathetic. Pathetic. But yeah, that's what they do, you know, to win. They're really aggressive group. As the big bacteria talks, you know. I'm on this catch at the moment that we're all just a bunch of bacteria talking, and depending on what you eat, certain bacteria talks certain ways and certain bacteria talks other ways, you know. So if you're the meat eater, you're eating that you're just the pig bacteria talking, you know. You're the cow bacteria talking. It's like you're getting your chance, your moment, you know what I mean? Because do you want to talk like a pig? A pig, not like a pig's bacteria. So I don't know, it's just my weirdness at the moment. Okay, did I have anything else? Yeah, the vegan, the PETA has a very fun blow up turkey that you can put. It's 5 foot tall, and you can put it in the front of your garden, out there in your yard, and it says yes veggies, no turkeys. And it's a massive turkey that you inflate. So I thought it was kind of cute. Anyway, I'm trying to show you what I'm up to. I have a little tiny garden area, okay, and it's like a front entrance courtyard zone. So I made like on a spreadsheet, I went and made like this, you see this pathway? This is what I'm working on. It was uneven. This is what I've been talking about the last two or three videos. It's completely uneven here and here. It was risen up because of this tree. I have a tree. And the roots had gone through and curled around underneath the path. All of this, they've gone through and they've shot around and curled up. And then the even larger roots. And so I've been taking this poor little tree. It was too close to the house where they put it, because the house wall is right here, which is less than like 5 feet. So I've had to go through and cut a ditch all the way around the tree, a big ditch, and sever the roots. So I've been cutting the roots back, but they're really only about a foot and a half deep that I could go. There are roots even deeper, so it's still there. And then today, I had to use the axe. I chopped them with an axe. I've been like, what do you call it, manual laborer woman. You cannot believe, unbelievable. And so I chopped them with the axe. I used the pickaxe sometimes, but yeah, the axe is the best way to go for the roots. When they're large ones. Okay, so when I went up into the tree today, now, and I got off the ladder, and I walked along, I didn't walk, but yeah, I shimmied along the larger branches to get the others. And I carried my little electric drill with me. It was a Ryobi, don't tell. It was a Ryobi. And I'm like, I got the cheapest one on the market, and then at the same time, the little shoe at the bottom of it that holds it to the boards had been broken off for a while. And that fell off while I was trying to cut all of these things. Just tried to have a, what do we call it? So I had this shoe thing that kept flopping around, and that was almost heavier than the handheld thing that I was holding on to, the jigsaw. Okay, and it's just a tiny blade, so it'll only do so much. And then I'm like, it's not working. And I'm not tool smart, and I realized that after about half hour, I realized that I had it turned on like a minimum. There's a minimum power, and then there's a maximum power. And then I put it on the maximum power, and all of a sudden, there it goes. You know, there goes a branch down to the ground. So yeah, it was quite easy all of a sudden. But it is so sad. But it's the only way that I can spare the foundation, because this tree is playing games. Now here, all along in here. Is a new hedge that I designed, and so I'm putting the special plants. So I do this all on the spreadsheet, because each one has a different color. This is a very floral here, and so each one has a different color. So I don't want all the purples taking over one section, and then having everything really bright and clowny, you know, yellow and red. So I'm an intermingler type, so I wanted to know where my flowers were going to do along the way, and their color tones. So, and I got a Miranda rose bush, which is beautiful. And all of these that I got were really, really cheap. They were like $5 compared to their normal price of $25. And I'm like, what an idiot that I would ever buy the high price. It's only this November time, it's only this like end of the year, end of the garden season. So gosh dang it, I mean, really good prices. Maybe they're not the plants that I desire, but they're gonna be fine. They're gonna be fine as a hedge zone. So next I have the, what is the thing? I got a Barbados. They're really tiny, but they were given them for $2, and I'm very happy about it. This is the Pride of Barbado, okay? And it can be trained into a tree, a really big fluffy tree, so we'll see what happens with it, a Pride of Barbado, and for $2, so we'll see about that tree. But so this is where I am at. I have four pavers. And I have more to lay out again, and then after that, I'm going to make decorations on top of the whole deal. I'm going to put stones and just more decor, mosaics or whatever. But I put in all these. I got a bougainvillea today. I have a blue girl rose bush. Heavenly bamboo, which I wasn't actually so happy with because it only grows 30 inches tall, and I kind of wanted higher because this is more like a fence, a hedge fence. Too late. And then it has like a red sumac tone, so I'm not absolutely happy about heavenly bamboo. We have the leucos. Now leucos, they're very, very much here in the desert. Where are they? They're kind of a sage tone, very quiet, light green, a leucophyllum. Now leucophyllum, I don't know if you see that. They can get pretty big and pretty tall, and you can turn them, and they're very dense, and they make those little tiny purple flowers. But very pale leaves, like an aloe, a soft furry leaves. And those you can hedge trim any way or shape topiary. Okay, so I'm very happy with them. What else did I get? I don't know. There's one that's really big and tall and bushy with purple flowers, and I have no idea. But right now it's in its youth, so it's more like sticks. Anyway, so what else was in there? Anything? Ah, butterfly bush. Now butterfly bush. Gosh, I was almost resentment online. I seeked it out. People were like, "Oh, it doesn't. It's not really where the butterflies live. It's not really their host plant. They just eat from it." I got almost like these people just like kick out the butterfly bush. You know, they're like they were tired of them. But anyway, so I put butterfly bush in anyway. so that was cool. And oh, I got a holly. I love hollies. Now, I know they're prickly, but oh my gosh, they are wonderful hedge blockers. They keep the wind out. The birds go in and nest. Hollies are very, very good, and then they have often those little berries as a ornament moment. So hollies are fabulous. Can't go wrong with hollies. You just have to trim them back. You can't let them sprout out because of they will hurt along the pathway. That's all. They're just one of those, but they are easy to maintain. They're not like the fire thorn. Okay, so back to the fun of this border area, this border region. Heavy metal girls, oh my gosh. I went to a metal exhibit. It was a mixed media exhibit of the students at the university. They are mostly women. I could not believe it. I was like, there's only two guys that I was looking at. I was only really looking at the metal art that they had made in the exhibits. Fabulous. We're talking fabulous. Just wonderful designers here in this border region. And the locomotive group was women. So unusual for my brain waves, because I was shocked. I always think of, oh, welders, you know, men, rough and tough. But no, it's the opposite. It was a women, and they're making little dainty things. They're making, one made little tiny miniature mailboxes. All kinds of funny things going on. And yet, yeah, the standard sculptor, heavy metal sculptor. There it is, a blob of doing something. But really talented group, and each one was distinguishably its own creative moment, and it wasn't like a copy of the other over there and a copy of that one over there. So that was very nice. It was a clean slate. It was like each artist had his or her own direction. You know what I mean? They weren't photocopying each other. And I'm going to be like you, and I'm going to be like you. Very, very original. So I was really, really proud of that group. Really good. So if you get a time or a chance, it's something that is very stimulating to go to the art exhibits at your local universities. You can really find an interesting group. Anyway, so that's my big hello. And when you're doing any of these things, my gosh, use this type of control. It really helps. It helps like the flow of the day, so that you get the work done like without your brain space going, what the heck? What am I doing next? I'm completely lost. It's a map, you know. It's a map you can use, and you don't get lost. And speaking of maps, I was looking at the train maps of the world. They have some very good ones at your local international studies at your university. So if you go to your international studies department, they have very good train maps of the world. They don't talk about the dangers, of course, but there is a train that goes all the way from the United States down to even Brasilia. They were trying to advertise that one. There's one that goes by Ecuador, the rainforest, goes through Honduras. It keeps going through all of those, Costa Rica, Panama. There's all of those, even Colombia, it'll hit. So you can go through those trains. Anyway, so I'm very, very hyped for them, and yet they're not really advertising them. They're probably not saying women alone don't do it, or even, you know, in a group you're going to be robbed. I don't know. Nobody was saying that, but I didn't get the feeling that it was a, hey, you know, go for it. But either way, there's maps up to Canada, there's maps of trains all over the place. So it's a good thing, you know, when you feel trapped or like, what is the word? When you feel sequestered in, you know, it's nice to look at those things because they are absolute escapes immediate. Even if just in fantasy moments, even if like, oh my God, I can get away, I could do that, you know. And then the next thing is like, well, how do I meet up with? How do I meet up with somebody and have a partner, a travel partner? And I can travel, I can go from Europe all the way down to South Africa. How would I do that, you know? I need a partner. I need travel partners on the train. And yet, I have seen women out there on their own. I've seen them out there on their own, traveling. I've met them. And I'm just, I don't know. It's back to the guts, you know. Do I have the guts to do that? Yeah. Anywho. Yeah, slow train to China. Yeah, there are slow trains to China. So all of that exists. You can try it, and you can throw your, what is that? Or you can use that along the way. Join your woofers, or they have many of those woofer organizations. It's not only the woofer one. There was like five of them that I was finding that are very, they'll match you up with places to go. You can go, you know, dig at somebody's agricultural, you know, house farm or whatever. But anyway. So with my design, I'll tell you this. So because I have this, I know I'm popping all over the place today. I'm going to take this drip irrigation across, and I'm going to go into this section along the wall, where before it never had a chance to have an arena of plants. It was just regular paver stone. So I'm shrinking actually the walkway, and I'm allowing a little bit of shade tolerance here, and possibly a bench. I'm not sure about the bench, but yeah, shade tolerant plant zone here and here. So that's the fun, that's what I'm doing. The super fun with my, I have the blue angel rose bush. And Miranda. Now Mirandas, if you look them up online, they are so beautiful. They use them for weddings. Oh, I'm just a rose freak. Okay guys, that's it. That's it for now.